Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord is one of the most anticipated PC exclusives coming this year. In this video, I'll be taking a look at everything you need to know about the game so far. Bannerlord is a prequel to the last game, Warband, taking place 200 years prior. The game will witness the last years of the Kaladesh Empire and the rise of the kingdoms. The Mountain Blade lore wasn't really fleshed out in Warband. Some factions had in-game details about their backgrounds, but there was no overarching story. With Bannerlord, Tailworlds are trying to offer an emotionally grabbing narrative while still keeping the sandbox spirit. They want the player to live through the fall of the Kaladesh Empire, similar to what it would have been like to live through the decline of Rome. In the beginning of the game, a semi-scripted set of linked quests will give the player the opportunity to learn about the various factions and have the chance to meet the key personalities, and hopefully that will give you the choice of picking one over the other. After that, the game will revert back to a full sandbox mode, but the game will still provide plenty of story. Bannerlord has made many leaps forward. The game has much better graphics, but at the same time, Tailworlds doesn't want to sacrifice on gameplay nor performance. The game is now lush with much more color, vibrance, and detail. They're also attempting to make the animations as natural as possible. Even if something as simple as reloading a crossbow isn't going to have a dramatic effect on gameplay, it's still crucial to the team that it looks like an actual crossbow being reloaded, so you'll hardly notice. Instead, if it looks like the character's bones are made of jelly and it doesn't seem natural, the player will notice, and that will have a negative impact on their overall experience. To make the animations as best as possible, they use a motion capture studio, allowing for a much more realistic result, as it'll pick up more of the subtle, natural movements. Obviously, not everything can be motion captured. Bringing in a horse in the studio might not be the best idea, but what they can, they will do. The world in Bannerlord is much more living and has a sense of authenticity. For example, if you walk into a tavern, people will be sitting, drinking, stretching, and talking. The team wants to make Kalradia as living and realistic as possible. Music is also a big focus in Bannerlord, with the game having 6 different factions. Tailworlds wanted music that would identify with each of them. Attention to detail is big, and the soundtrack will reflect the setting along with all the different cultures in the game. Gameplay has also taken a step forward. The siege system is given a massive upgrade, including multiple siege engines and types fully usable by the player or the AI. The siege weapons are freely placed by the player, so there's full control over how to assault walls. Once a siege begins, you can order your troops what to do on the fly throughout battle. The terrain for combat is much more varied, and the AI has been brought up a notch. The AI know how to keep out of range for attacks while moving in closer to strike. They aren't just stationary, mindless targets. The inventory screen also features an improved AI that offers the player direct control. Switching between equipping the player and companions is a simple click away. Items can be easily sorted or filtered. Hotkeys will make it simple to buy, loot, and sell items. Tooltips provide comparisons between equipped and selected items. It'll make the overall experience much more streamlined for the player. Another new feature is the weapon crafting. Weapons are separated into parts that can be exchanged with any kind of combination. It's also possible to tweak the exact length of a certain part, such as blades, to get the kind of weapon you want. All of the parts have their own physical properties. This will assess the center mass and balance of a weapon, which changes the speed and damage. This allows for each weapon to feel very unique. One more nice addition is the inclusion of a replay system. Any battle, single or multiplayer, is saved directly and can be rewatched from any angle and be slowed down. Bannerlord shares the setting of Kalradia with Warband, but it's also expanded to include regions further to the east and south of that in previous games, resulting in a map which is around 3 times larger. Some of the exact features of the land and some settlements from previous games are recognizable. The game's overworld map is where a large amount of the gameplay will occur, and it will offer a lot of information to the player. You can see what a village is producing by going over it, and on the HUD, more info is present, including morale, food supplies, gold, etc. Characters and locations on the map make up what is known as parties. All parties on the map, whether they are lords, bandits, hideouts, or anything else, have a role in the game's sandbox simulation. Here's an example of the economy system. Villages will produce goods based on what type of production they have in place. Peasants take goods produced in their village to sell to a local town by repeatedly traveling between the village and the town on the map. The raw materials are taken to towns and either consumed or processed into secondary goods via workshops. And then goods are brought by caravans to be sold elsewhere for a higher price. When all of these steps are completed, the prosperity of the settlements increase. However, because everything is so connected, disrupting one piece of the puzzle is a very effective way in dealing with an enemy or rival. You could prevent peasants from making their journey to the local town, leading to the town suffering due to there being a lack of goods to process for trade. Since everything is simulated, whatever you do will start a domino effect in the world, positively or negatively. The idea is to manipulate the economy to make progress. The topography of the map in Bannerlord is mountainous. This causes an increased number of choke points. Battles are often fought to contest key choke points with the goal of securing passage for trade caravans and other parties. Tactically, the map is expected to offer much more options for controlling areas that serve as trade routes. The map is also ever-evolving, not just by the player or NPCs, but by the passing of time. Change in seasons affect the weather, changing the landscape and sending snow headed south during the winter. The gameplay will also be altered in the changing of the seasons. For example, cavalry and range units will have a harder time in rain or snow. The yearly cycle will now be 12 weeks and will add more importance to the changing of the seasons and aging of the characters. You can see that Mountain Blade 2 is making many strides over its predecessor. The game looks very thought out and the detail and content seem staggering. So that's everything you need to know about Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. Let me know, are you excited for the game? Will you be picking it up on day one? Comment your thoughts down below. And as always guys, thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.